Okay guys, we're back. It's been a long time away, quite a lot of hard work, and the work's not over yet. So now number one thing I have to do is set the tent back up. We need to clean it, we need to dry it, we need to make sure we can get it stored properly for winter so I don't deal with any mold, mildew issues or anything like that. And for some reason, somehow, this is what, November 7th, and it's supposed to be 71 degrees and sunny today, and it's supposed to be at least 60s to 70s for the next few days. So this is actually going to be 100% perfect for getting the tent set up and getting it cleaned out, dried out, and aired out, and ready to go for the next time we use it. So let's get this thing set up real quick, and then we'll show you what the aftermath of the inside of the tent looks like. Now, if you guys remember, we got dropped off on the island pretty late, so by the time we set up camp, it was dark. So unfortunately, I really couldn't set the camera up. Couldn't see anything for setting the tent up. We just set it up, put in our sleeping bags, and basically went to bed. We were pretty beat that day. So one of the things you guys might have missed is we did actually get a ground covering for the tent to sit on, which will help keep the underneath side of the tent clean. And this packed right into the bag with all the rest of the tent components. It's not a very thick tarp, so it's not something I would trust, you know, for a long period of time, but for a tent base, this will work absolutely perfectly. And it folds up real small and it's light. So we're gonna get this set up first. This was one of the tricks that you guys missed, one of the additions. So we'll get this set up first. And I think this time I'm going to enlist some help so this goes even faster. So you guys can help.
Okay.
Staked out, put the poles in it, and get it set up. Okay, guys. There you have it. Tent's all set up. And it's really nasty in there. So let's take you inside. And we'll take you inside and kind of show you around and some of the cleaning we gotta do. All right, so going inside, you can see, hopefully you can see, when you roll it up, you just get this moisture and there's dirt and sand all over everything. Okay, so looking around here, you could see all this stuff was originally either from the floor or it was on the outside of the tent, and you leave the door unzipped when you roll this thing. So all this stuff, you see all the moisture that was built up in here from rolling it when it was still wet, and all the debris. So basically what we have to do is sweep the inside of this, starting all the way from the top. All the walls, I mean, you could still see even over here just by rubbing or rolling this thing up, you end up with, you know, all this crap all over the sides of the walls. So basically what we have to do is sweep from the top down, and then we sweep the whole floor out. And I actually bring in some big old bath towels that the wife doesn't mind me using, and we'll actually start kind of scrubbing this floor bottom just to try to make sure we get it clean. So that's going to be the next step on the process for getting this thing cleaned up and ready for storage. And it's very important that you get these dry and clean before storing them. There's nothing worse than spending a bunch of money on a good quality tent and storing it improperly and having it go bad on you. So we're gonna get this all cleaned out and stored properly so we can use it again next year. And that's it for the tent for today. So I wanna thank you guys for tuning in. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. If you have any questions or suggestions, maybe on how to try to eliminate this without actually having to sweep and wipe it all down and all that other stuff. I can't do that on the island, it's just not practical. So leave me your comments and your suggestions. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe. And this is Mike with Mansplaining.